So Sage is kind of off. Before I start, I just want to apologise about the noise of the dryer in the background. It's just a stand dryer just to kind of keep it warm really and to start to dry the coat off. I'm not going to blast the coat, I'm not going to use a very high powered dryer on the coat. I'm not going to fluff dry him because I don't want to damage these curls. If you fluff, I do occasionally fluff dry, which is when you've got a really sort of intense and strong blaster, which opens out the coat and straightens the hair. There are, if the coat gets really, really matted, sometimes I do resort to that. But in general, I prefer just to dry them as naturally as possible. So that's all in the background, so hopefully that doesn't interfere with what I'm saying to you, and I hope that you can hear from me. So my arsenal of tools for doing this job. Metal comb, the most important tool. This is like a slicker, it's a very old one, I've used it for, and I only really use it for this job, to break up the curls and break up and pull out, the curls. But I only really use it for this, I don't use it for general grooming. I've got my thinners, so the double-sided serrated scissors that if I come across a really bad mat, I know there's one on the top here, I will just get hold of the hair at the base and do a couple of snips with that and then tease it out, the hair out with the comb for this mat break. And this is a good tool also. You have to hold the hair at the base of the skin because otherwise you're going to run the risk of scratching him and also pulling against the skin. The Legato skin is much thinner than most breeds because they've got this thick wool coat protecting it. They don't need that really thick skin that most other dogs have. But you do have to be careful when you're dematting. So I'm going to start at the head. As I say, I know that the base of the head here, I knew it was getting quite bad. So as I say, I'm popping the skin between my one finger, a couple of snips, may not be enough, and then I can tease it out with the mat breaker. So you can see I pulled that quite a bit there. That's okay, you've got such a thick coat. As I say, you've got to do it at this stage. I've left it so it's a month now since I've actually combed you through, which is a little bit too long really. In an ideal world, I'll do it every 2 to 3 weeks. In the areas where it laps badly, the areas that you have to be a bit careful of are the neck, the head area, under the ears, the legs, they're the worst areas really, and the chest. That's now coming. Now I get my comb through. Yeah, this is going to be a long job because I've left it so long. It's silly of me to have left it this long, but I've been busy. But, I'll work my way through this, and at the end you'll have a nice matte-free coat that I can then start to trim. I will show you at the end the finished finished product.